Faith moves.
Yes.
You hear me? Faith moves. Faith is not faith unless it is followed by obedience. You hear what I said? Faith is not faith unless it's followed by obedience. Faith is not faith until the point of execution.
Right.
It's not faith until the point of execution. Abraham had a mindset of obedience. Then the Bible says, it goes down and says that as they begin journeying, it says, he saw the place a far way off. What's the place? The place that God told him about. Saw the place a far way off, meaning that he hadn't arrived yet. Somebody say, I haven't arrived yet.
I haven't arrived yet.
But I see a little bit of it.
Yes.
Come on, say it again. Say, I haven't arrived yet.
I haven't arrived
say,
yet.
I haven't attained it yet.
I haven't attained it
but
yet.
I see it in my future.
I see it in my future.
The minute that God gives you a glimpse of your future, ladies and gentlemen, something has got to be cut down. One, in order to get to the next level, something's got to die.
Wow.
He says, sacrifice your son Isaac and offer him as a burnt offering.
Wow.
The whole thing has got to be destroyed. I'm taking you somewhere that you don't even realize yet.
Wow.
What God is doing in your life, you have no idea.
That's right. That's right.
This thing is for the greater glory.
Yeah.
You, our minds cannot really fathom the glory of God.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
So God is taking you somewhere. So something has got to die to get to the next level. But then when you see it in the distance, there has to be some disconnections that take place. If you're going to the next level and all your same people still love you, they're still around you, there's absolutely nothing different. But let me tell you something, boy, let me just talk to myself. When people start walking away from you and leaving you, maybe it means that God is about to take you to a higher level, to another dimension. All right? You know what makes you tick. What is your mindset? A mindset is this. A mindset is your attitude. A mindset is your behavior. Mindset is what triggers you. Right? So what we want is for our mindsets to be changed, to become mindsets like these brothers that we're talking about today. Two. So we have a mindset of obedience. Watch this. The Bible says that he got up and he went. Second mindset. When he saw the place, what's the place? The place that God told him to now go. Where is that? Mount Moriah. He told him to now go there, and that is going to be the place that you offer your son as a burnt offering. When he saw it in a distance, somebody say in a distance. When he saw it a far way off, he said this to his accompanying companions, because there were some people, some brothers who came with them. They were going up to the mountain. He says, y'all stay here. Say that. Say y'all.
Y'all.
Stay here.
Stay.
Say it again. Say y'all.
Y'all.
Stay here.
Stay here.
It's southern slang. Y'all. Y'all stay here. So he says, y'all stay here. He says, the boy and I are going to worship. One. You get these two mindsets really quick. One. He recognized this. That when you see the place in a distance, there's got to be some disconnections that take place, or some disconnecting that takes place. When do I know to separate from certain people? When do I know that it's time for my core group of friends to change? When do I know it's time for some relationships to end? Now you'd have known that this relationship is not conducive to your destiny for quite some time. But now that God has given you a glimpse into your future, perhaps it's time to tell some people, y'all stay here. When you know it, when you can see it, when God's given you a revelation, something's got to shift. Guess what? You know that you're getting closer to that place that God has prepared. Come on, hello? I'm getting closer to the prophesied place. So I say, I'm getting closer to the prophesied place. Say it again. Say, I'm getting closer to the prophesied place. Anybody had somebody walk out on them recently? All right, 5 years ago? Within 5 years? Within a year? All right. People turned their back. You lost some friends. You lost some people. Come on, you're getting closer to the prophesied place. Amen? All right. So he says, y'all stay here. And then he says this to them, though. And this is the mindset. He says, the boy and I are going to worship.